Welcome to Go Botany, New England Wildflower Society's award-winning guide to all of the plants of New England and beyond. This tutorial introduces you to the basic features of Go Botany, including our simple key to 1,200 of the most common native and naturalized species in New England, and our sophisticated search tool. You can also explore PlantShare, which is a community of plant enthusiasts online, or our advanced ID tools, which includes an interactive key to all of the 3,500 species of plants in New England, and a technical dichotomous key, plus our teaching tools for teachers in all sorts of environments. You can also see at the upper right our search box. Here you can type in a scientific name and get search results. You can also type in a common name and get search results. And what if you know about a outdated name, such as Cornus, the genus that used to be for dogwoods? It's a very forgiving search tool and will give you search results as well. You can navigate by clicking on any of these species names, which will direct you to a very information-rich species identification page. But let's begin with the simple ID key. Let's pretend you have a mystery plant to identify. Click on the big orange button to go there. Here on this new page, you'll see that we'll ask you to choose one of six broad categories to which your plant may belong. Is it a woody plant? If you knock on it, does it knock back? Is it vaguely grass-like with long, narrow leaves? Are you snorkeling or otherwise wading into deep water in order to see this plant? In that case, it's probably aquatic, and so forth. To get an idea of these broad categories, read the general information about them, or view a video that will give you an introduction to the groups. Also, click on the arrows below the photograph to scroll through a series of representative photographs that will reflect the range of species that belong to this group. I'm going to select ferns, one of my favorite groups of plants, as an example group for my mystery plant. I click on the big orange button that says, "My plant is in this group." Once you've selected the broad group, you'll be brought to a new page that asks you to narrow down your group a bit further. Again, look carefully at your choice of subgroups. If you're not satisfied with your available choices, you can always use the breadcrumb trail at the top of the page or the back button in your browser to go back. I'm going to be choosing true ferns and moonworts as my group. Notice that I have narrowed down 1,200 possible species to only 45 in two easy steps. Now I press on the continue button to navigate to this page. Having selected that, I'm now ported to a page that have a very few species to choose from. You'll see a page full of thumbnail photos of beautiful ferns. But if you don't happen to have leaves of your ferns, or you have some other types of characteristics that you can observe about those ferns, you can actually filter these based on the characteristics that you can see. Now, browsing a whole bunch of photos is not the most efficient way to identify your plant. Instead, bring your cursor over to the part of the page that allows you to answer some meaningful questions about the characteristics of your plant. This part of the page may occur in different places depending on the platform that you're using. We are adapted for mobile phones, tablets, as well as desktop computers. Now, we've chosen these questions as the most easy to answer and also the most helpful for narrowing down the choices of possible plants. You can answer these questions in any order. Click on a question and a window will pop up with your possible answers. Let's start with plant growth form. Here I've chosen the question plant growth form, and you'll see some drawings that you can scroll over to enlarge. You might also see one of a very few technical terms. We have tried to minimize those technical terms, but sometimes they're necessary. But you will get a drawing and an easy to understand definition of those technical terms. I'm going to choose that the leaves grow from a rhizome growing at or below the ground. And I'll apply that selection. I'm down to 37 matching species at this point, and I can continue to answer questions in any order here. But perhaps I have an inkling as to which genus or family my fern might belong to. This is for those of you who know just enough to be dangerous, but let me just choose a random genus here. Now I'm down to 7 matching species. If you're unhappy with those choice of species, you can always clear and clear here. You can always get help at any stage along the way. But if I can't answer any more questions within this broad group, I can get more questions based on the features that I can see, perhaps growth form or leaves or even spores. I can pick my own questions based on the characteristics that I can see. A particularly useful feature. So I'm going to click on spores or spore cones, and you'll notice that the program has offered me 3 new questions based on the features that I've told it I can see. So I'll click on one of these and I will choose an answer. Now I'm down to 2 species. At this point, it's sufficient for you to actually look at your results set and click on them for a preview of the species, which you can do here. So you'll see some information about the species. You can also scroll through photographs that are informative about the species. If you're satisfied with your choice, you can now go to the species page, which will give you a lot of information about your species. First of all, you will see a number of scrolling photographs, any of which you can click on to get a high resolution version of that photograph. And we have actually gotten donations of photographs from 37,000 different donors. So it's a wonderful thing. And if you want more information on how to reuse those photographs, you can click up here for more information. You will also see a distribution map that shows where the species has been recorded in New England and also in North America. You have some interesting facts about the species, which will help you remember them in the future. You will see characteristics of the species, and in fact, if you want to know everything you ever wanted to know about the species, you can get all of the characteristics of the species, which will give you an idea of how rich our data are on these species. It has wetland status, it has information as to whether the species is rare or even invasive in a particular state. It will also give you technical information about how to identify it, or if there are hybrids or cultivars or varieties or subspecies that you need to know about. If the species is easily confused with another species, you can get information here about how to tell those species apart. If the species has ever been known by another name, you can peruse the synonyms section of the webpage to understand what other names it may have occurred with. You can learn about the family to which this species belongs and more about its genus. And again, you can always get help. So we hope that you'll enjoy using GoBotany, either simply searching for information on particular species about which you're interested, or helping you identify the species that you want to learn more about. This is the most comprehensive, continuously updated guide to the plants of New England, assembled with funding from the National Science Foundation. Thanks.